Pinging in pellets can be a great tactic all year round, but it's especially good in the springtime. Just as it starts warming up, fish start looking around a bit more, they need a bit more feed, higher metabolism, and that bait hitting the water can attract fish into your peg, and it can be a deadly tactic. Typically use hard pellets, normally in a 6mm, depends on the size of fish. If there's a lot of F1s, maybe a 4mm. Mixture, 6s, if I'm fishing with great big carp, then maybe 8s. But typically it's a fishery pellet, so today we've got some blue Woodlands View pellets. It's what the fish are used to seeing, so you know they're switched on to fish to feeding on those pellets. So if I do have a choice of what pellets to use, then I look for a good high quality feed pellet that's nice and uniform, a nice colour, and a bag should be plenty for a session. The long pole line, sort of 13, 14, maybe longer, is a great place to feed pellets. It's often quite a long way to ship out and put in all the time, so by loose feeding that line with a catapult, you can keep that bait going in all the time, even when you're fishing other lines, and keep that twin ticking over, and hopefully there's always a few fish there to be caught. So at the start of the session, plumb up to sort of the base of the bristle. Often it's quite silty, so you might have to plumb up again sort of mid-session. As the fish feed on the bottom, they'll disturb it, and it might actually get sort of, you know, some days it might even be 6 inches deeper by the end of the session, but that's the starting point, base of the bristle. And then as the day goes on, maybe it starts to warm up a little bit, I look for line bites on the float, and I'll let the fish tell me what's going on, and I might end up fishing shallow later on in the session. So rig choice today, to begin with, I've set up a 4x10 F1 maggot. It's a nice light float. I've got sort of a few number 10s strung out throughout the rig, and that's going to be my lighter rig. The idea behind that is because I'm pinging pellets, a lot of those fish are going to be intercepting it on the way down. So a lighter rig can help you catch those fish on the drop. But what I've also done today is set up a heavier rig. I've got a bit of an awkward crosswind, so I've got a 4x14, nice stable again. Same pattern, but this time I've got it bolt down to sort of combat the tow, and I've got 3 number 10 droppers on that rig again. Hook length, I've started on an 011 to an 18 GPM. I've actually hooked a few bigger fish and pulled out of them, so I've stepped it up to a 16, which has helped me land those bigger fish. When you're pinging pellets, it's a little bit different to when you feed them with a pot. It's not really that important to be accurate. It's quite nice to sort of create a bit of an area, bait falling through, so when you are hooking fish, there's still going to be plenty going on and fish feeding confident, really. Obviously, you can switch it up and use a combination of a catapult and a cad pot to sort of focus the fish, and obviously that can help when it's really windy and you're struggling to get it accurate. But normally it doesn't really matter to be really accurate when you're pinging pellets. So another great way of fishing is to use a combination of a catapult and a cad pot. What you can do is attract fish into your peg with a catapult, but then maybe put 5 pellets into a cad pot, ship out, be nice and accurate, lay your rig over the top, and you're setting like a little trap in amongst that loose feed, and that can get you a few more bites. So my hook baits are exactly what I'm loose feeding with, just a simple hard pellet. It's what they're used to seeing, it's what I'm feeding, so it makes sense to fish the same bait on the hook. It's also a nice heavy bait, nice and stable, so a little crosswind like today, it's quite a nice bait to fish. Now and again I might mix it up, maybe fish a cube of meat on the hook. It could be quite a nice standout bait and it sinks slower. Likewise, in the winter, maybe a grain of corn might stand out, but normally it's a simple hard pellet that does the damage. So although we're in springtime, it can be a great tactic all year round. I've caught fish doing this in the middle of winter. Just depends on the venue. Sometimes they shut up a little bit, but just rattling a few pellets in can be a great way of catching fish. It's one of the main reasons why pinging pellets is so effective is the noise it makes. It drags fish into your peg, but it doesn't overfeed them. You can, you know, it's amazing sometimes when you can feed. Those pellets hit the water, but a few seconds later, it gets you that bite. And at the same time, although that you've just fed, you're not really overfeeding it because you're creating it over a decent little area, and that trickle of bait going in all the time is not really going to overfeed them. But at the same time, it's making lots of attraction and bringing those fish into your peg. The only thing I might do in preparation on the bait front is if it's fishery pellets and they might not be good quality, then I'll add some sinking pellet oil to it. What that does is it slows the breakdown a little bit, ensures all those pellets sink to the bottom the right way you need them. So actually working the rig when you're fishing is really important. Obviously you're loose feeding all the time, that bait's dropping through, but by achieving the same thing with your rig and lifting and dropping, you're going to get a lot more bites, and quite often when you're dropping it through you can catch those bigger fish that, you know, are a bit wiser and don't pick those baits off of the bottom where they know they're going to get caught. So working the rig, lifting and dropping, could get you a lot more bites. So as the weather's warming up, we're getting cold nights and sunshine in the day warming up, it can be quite effective to fish shallow. Obviously, to begin with, I might try and catch on the bottom, you know, and sort of be careful with what I'm feeding. But as the day goes on and as the weather warms up, it can be worth trying shallow. So today I've also got a 4x10 carp shallow set up. With that, I can alter the depth, see where the fish are. I've actually had a little go today and I've actually caught them at about 2.5 foot, which is, you know, not in the middle of summer, but you know, they're coming up, and hopefully few weeks time they'll come even shallower than that. So the key thing is to read your bites and see what's happening. Let the fish tell you what's going on. Well, today for instance, I've lowered my rig in and I've actually caught a few fish as the rig's going through. I've also had a few liners, so then what I've done is I've shipped out with a shallow rig. Started off 18 inch, no bites, so then I've gone down deeper, sort of 3 foot, 2.5 foot, and I've started catching a few F1s. So it's worth letting the fish tell you where they are, what they want, and then go from there. Foul hookers can be a problem with this method, especially when you're making lots of noise and bait falling through the water. But there are a few things you can do. One thing is when you feed in pellets and there's a lot of fish there, then just lift your rig out the water, wait a few seconds and then lower it back in. What's happening when you're feeding and you're getting liners is those fish are sort of rushing around looking for the bait. But if you lift your rig out and just wait until it calms down a bit, often you can get those proper bites then. Alternatively, you can, you know, concentrate those fish with a cab pot, like I said earlier, and keep their noses in one place if you like, and then you're more likely to hook fish in the mouth. It's not just a tactic for carp, it's a great way of catching F1s and even skimmers and bream. A lot of venues with a lot of silver fishing, you can catch some great big skimmers and bream weights on just pinging hard pellets. Likewise, on commercial venues where you're faced with open water, it can be a great way of catching F1s.